My name is Grace. Today I'm going to read the Bible story. A Tale of Twin Brothers. Isaac's mother, Sarah, lived to be 127 years old, while his father, Abraham, lived to 175, but the time they both died. Isaac had married a girl called Rebecca from Abraham's old town, far off Haran. Isaac inherited his father's farming. Business and state in Canada following God's will, just as Abraham had done. Like Isaac's father and mother, Rebecca had to wait a long time before God sent them children. 20 years it was worth the wait for the Rebecca finally found herself expecting a baby. It was not one, but two twins. A short time before they were born, God told Rebecca, You're having two sons. You will lead two peoples. One boy will be stronger than the other, and the other will serve the younger one. At the birth, a very strange thing happened. The second baby came out holding the first one's feet. He wanted to pull his other brother back and overtake Isaac. And Rebecca called the elder boy Esau, because the name meaning hairy, and Esau was dark and had lots of hair. They named their younger fair son Jacob, which means someone who wants to seize some boy easily's place. Time passed and the twins grew very different in personality, as well as looked. Jacob was quiet and thoughtful. He loved spending time at home with his mother and in the kitchen. And they become very close. However, Esau was strong and brave. He loved roaming around outside, and he became an excellent hunter. Esau was his favorite son. Who, whenever Jacob saw his father and brother together talking and laughing in easy companionship, he couldn't help but wish that he was loved best by Isaac. Instead, to make matters worse, because Esau had been born before Jacob, the law said the Esau was to be given all of their father's wealth when he died. This was called his birthright. Jacob knew that he was clever than Esau and better suited to running his father business. He couldn't stand to think that it was Esau's birthright to take it over eventually. One day, Jacob was in the kitchen cooking a delicious bean sweet stew when Esau arrived back from a hunt. Ooh, what's that? Strange, he exclaimed, bending over the cooking pot and breathing in the Can I have some now? He begged. Jacob's eyes glittered. It was a sudden idea. I will give you some stew. He replied, if you promise to give me all your rights as the firstborn son. Done, agreed Esau. All he could think about was his rumbling stomach, burning with hunger. If I don't get anything to eat within the next 5 minutes, I will fall over and die away. So what use would my birthright to be then? He joked. But Jacob was quite serious. Say you solemnly swear he isn't. I solemnly swear, promise, Esau. Now, come on, give me that stew. Chico ladled some stew into a bowl and gave Izu some soft bread, and both twins sat back hungrily, pleased. 20 years passed, and Isaac was an old, blind man who knew he didn't have long to live. One of Isaac's last wish was for Izu to hunting for meat for his favorite meal. Afterwards, Isaac was going to give his eldest son the blessing that Ophikil gave him his bright red. Izu gladly set off with his bow and across at once. But Rebecca had overheard it. All at once, a place came to her to take her husband. Into giving her future son Jacob the blessing. Instead, first she quickly cooked the meal her husband had asked for. Then she hurried, dressed Jacob in Elsa's clothes so he would smell like his brother, and wrapped Goosekin around his arm. And Nick, so he would feel hairy like his brother too. But protest Jacob, I will take the blame. Rebecca reassured her son and sent him in with the food to see his father. The trick wouldn't work properly. Isaac was at first because by the time the tasty dinner had arrived so quickly. But Jacob said that God had helped him in his hunting. Jacob copied Isaac's voice, and of course the smell and felt like his brother too. Isaac was fooled. Into taking that Jacob was Izu and gave him all important right blessing. When Izu arrived back from the hunt and went to his father, They both quickly realized they had been tricked. How they wept with Fursten and regret. However, it was too late. The old man could not take back his blessing. Later, a private issue began to feel angry. "I will wait until father dies," he swore to himself, "but no longer than that, I shall have my revenge on Jacob." Yes, today I'll read this much. Next time I'll read Jacob's dream. It was fun, then bye!